Hi, Bob Swanson, ICC astronomy instructor here again, and I wanted to share with you a tool that will help you in learning your moon phases. This is not something you have to make, but perhaps by making it, you'll get a better understanding of the different moon phases, not just their shapes. You know, to me, that's kind of kids' play. But what's really cool about the moon phases is if you recognize the shapes, you can also understand the time of day, as well as the direction you're looking. So a moon phase can tell you not only what time of day it is, but also in which direction you're looking. Because it turns out that not all moon phases are viewable at certain times of the day. And you know, sometimes the moon isn't even up in the sky at nighttime. And this little tool will help you understand that a little bit better. So you'll learn the orientations of the Earth, the Moon, and the Sun for different moon phases, as well as you'll learn the rise and set times of different phases of the moon, as well as the directions you would have to be looking in order to see a particular moon phase. Now, this activity I did not come up with on my own. I actually learned this, or found this, from an astronomy instructor at a community college in Michigan. His name is Kevin Denhey. He teaches at Delta College, and he came up with this really cool moon phase dial. And I'll provide a link to this printout. So if you want to, you print it out on a nice, maybe a nice card stock would be good. And it's just two pieces. This piece, which you'll cut out around the black line, and then this bottom piece that you'll cut around the black line. And then you just attach them together with a paper fastener, and you've got yourself a moon phase dial. And it looks like this. And one thing that's important when you're using the moon phase dial is to always keep the half circle, this horizon piece, horizontal. So you hold on to that piece, and then you just move the other piece. That's this piece that has a little handle on it. That's the one that's going to be in motion. And of course, the direction of motion is going to be from east to west. So you want to make sure that your sun is always rising in the east, and it winds up setting in the west. And that's really about pretty much how this thing works. Now let me show you how to use it to learn about the moon phases. Let's start out with an easy one. Let's start out with new moon. Now new moon, if you've read in the book, is when the moon is between the Earth and the sun. So you can first of all tell the orientation of your moon phase by looking at where the sun is, where the moon is, and we're going to pretend this is the Earth. This is the head of the Brad, is the Earth. So sure enough, for new moon phase, the moon has got to be between the sun and the Earth. That's new moon. And notice, the sun rises in the east, what time? 6 a.m. That's what that little arrow tells you. So it tells you the time of rise. And of course, the new moon is also rising at 6 a.m. And it climbs in the sky. Climbs in our, you know, in this case, you'd be looking to your southeast and your southeastern sky. Eventually, you'd be looking high in your southern sky. You'd see the sun, this is noontime. Sun is high in the southern sky for those of us who live in the mid-latitudes of the northern hemisphere. Of course, notice that the moon is still between the sun and the Earth. It stays that way. It stays in that same phase the entire day. In fact, over several days, it really is not going to change its phase very much. But notice that, yes, that's the orientation. Sun, moon, Earth for new moon phase. So at noontime, they're both high in the sky. And of course, at 6 p.m., the sun sets, as does the moon. That's why we don't see the new moon, because it's up in the sky during the daytime. And we are seeing that the side that is facing us, the side of the moon that is facing us, is not illuminated. And therefore, we don't see it. We call that a new moon. Let's move on to another moon phase. Let's take, for example, let's try to figure out when the first quarter moon rises. Now remember, the first quarter moon is when the moon's right side is lit up. The left side should be dark. So notice, okay, let's see, there's sunrise. Sun's rising. It's 6 a.m. I don't see first quarter yet. Ah. There's our first quarter moon. So notice at noontime, when the sun is high in our sky, look over here. There's the first quarter moon. It's rising. Now we would likely not see that moon in the sky. Even though light is being reflected off the moon and heading in our direction, we'd probably not see it because it wouldn't be enough light. Notice that the sun is still in the sky. It's going to be flooding the atmosphere with sunlight, and therefore too much competition. We wouldn't see this light. Now maybe by the late afternoon, as we move on toward 6 p.m., notice the sun is about to go down, and notice that, now the first quarter moon is high in my sky. And most likely we would see it at this point. And certainly, once the sun goes down and there's no more competition, I'd certainly see that first quarter moon. But really, for just a window between 6 p.m. and notice at midnight that first quarter moon sets. And notice the orientation as well. For in order to have a quarter moon phase, in this case the first quarter moon phase, notice the orientation of sun, earth, moon. They've all got to be at right angles to each other. That gives you a quarter phase, in this case the first quarter phase. So the first quarter rises at about noontime, climbs high in the sky at 6 p.m., and then will set around midnight. That's pretty much it. I'm going to make another video that's going to give you a little more practice using this lunar phase dial. Like I said, this is just a supplemental thing. You don't have to make this, but I think that it might help you understand some of the lunar phase simulator stuff that's part of the lab activity, and as well as just supplement your knowledge about the moon phases. So I hope you enjoyed it, and like I said, look out for the next video that's going to give you a little more practice using the lunar phase dial. It's actually going to quiz you a little bit more about moon phases. We'll see you in a few minutes.